Parashurama. Parikshit asked Sage Shuka, "O sage, Parashurama was a Brahmin. Why did he leave off his sattvic qualities and follow rajasic and tamasic qualities? Why did he destroy all the rulers on the face of the earth, and that too 21 times? How was the earth relieved of her burden by this action, by his action? Please explain their implications." In reply to this humble doubt, Sage Shuka narrated to him the story of Parashurama. Once there was a king by name Kartavirya Arjuna. He was also known by the name of Sahasrarjuna. He was a great emperor of the Haihaya dynasty. He was a great devotee of Dattatreya. Through his worship, he obtained a great many powers, 1,000 hands to fight, a golden chariot that went wheresoever he willed it to go, superhuman yogic powers, mighty strength, vitality, and unexhausted sense organs, wealth and prosperity, and the power to win his enemies. Undaunted, he wandered over the whole world. There was none to stand against him and fight. One day, he was taking a bath in the river Reva, Narmada, along with his ladies. Just as a pastime, he obstructed the waters of the river with his 1,000 hands so that the ladies could have a good bath. His action inundated the plains high up, where Ravana, king of Lanka, with 10 heads and 20 hands, had camped, having come on a conquering expedition. His whole camp got washed away, and he grew angry against Arjuna. Arjuna caught him in his armpit, squeezed him, and made his servants play with this as if he was a monkey, and then let him off with a warning not to claim himself as a great hero thereafter. On another occasion, this Arjuna went for hunting to the forest with a good following. He was exhausted and hungry. By chance, he saw the hermitage of sage Jamadagni nearby. He went there for refreshing himself. The sage received him with due honor and gave a good feast to him and all his following, including the animals. They were fed more sumptuously with rich food than what the king could have given them, even at his own palace. But the king did not want to admire the greatness of the feast. He came to know that it was all due to the celestial powers of the Kamadhenu, the wish-yielding cow, which the sage possessed. He ordered his men to drive the cow and its calf to his capital without the consent of the sage, and even against his protestations and the protestations of the cow itself, and returned home. Sage Jamadagni had several sons, of whom Parashurama was the youngest. Parashurama returned to the ashramam soon after the king had left and came to know of the king's mischief. He got wild, took his patent axe and also his bow and arrows, and went to Mahishmatipuram, the capital of Kartavirya, and reached it even before the king. The king thought that a foolish Brahmin boy had come to fight, and so ordered his army on him. Parashurama destroyed the king's 15 battalions in no time. Seeing the utter defeat, Kartavirya got angry. He came out with 500 arms full of bows and 500 arms full of arrows to attack the little Brahmin boy. Parashurama cut off all his 1,000 arms like cutting sugarcane and chopped off his head with his axe as if it was a palm fruit. The 10,000 sons of the king ran away in all directions. Rama took the cow and its calf and reached home, prostrated before his father and explained his achievement. His father heard him patiently and then chastised him for taking on himself Kshatriya duties and condemned him because he had killed a great king for nothing. He said, "A king represents all the gods and the Brahman. You have killed such a king for no purpose. A Brahmin is great by virtue of his forgiveness. He shines by the glory of his patience. Killing the king is as good as killing Brahman. So you better go for a pilgrimage and visit all the holy places with your mind fixed on Lord Vishnu and come back. Accordingly, Rama went for a pilgrimage for 1 year and returned. One day, Renuka, mother of Parasurama, went to the river to fetch water for a sacrifice. In the river, Chitrarata, a Gandharva, was bathing with his ladies. Renuka, looking at the scene, was moved by the beauty of the Gandharva. Soon she recollected the sacrifice and returned with the water. A bit late and stood before the sage, shivering with fear. The sage, by intuition, understood what had taken place and asked his sons to sever her head, a sinful lady. His sons did not dare to such a crime. The sage called Parasurama, the youngest son, and asked him to put the lady and the disobedient sons also to death. Parasurama, without a protest, took his axe and severed the heads of all of them, because if he did not obey, he knew the sage would curse him. If he obeyed him, he would be pleased and grant him any boon he might ask for. His father congratulated Rama for his obedience and asked him to seek a boon. Immediately, Parasurama requested his father to revive all those who were lying dead there to life without a trace of the memory of their death in them. Jamadagni did accordingly and they all got up as if from a sleep. The sons of Kartavirya were waiting to take vengeance on Parasurama. When he had gone to the forest along with his brothers to fetch fuel, the king's son suddenly entered the ashramam and cut off the head of the sage Jamadagni, who was in deep meditation, and ran away with the head. Renuka cried aloud, and Rama and his brothers heard the cry and returned home. When Parasurama appeared, Renuka cried again, beating her chest 21 times. Rama advised his brothers to preserve the dead body of their father and went with his axe, bow and arrows to Mahishmatipura. He killed all the king's sons and their following. Not being satisfied, he went round the earth 21 times, destroying all the kings, leaving no trace of the Kshatriya race. He filled 9 lakes with their royal blood in Kurukshetra, which was thereafter called the Samanta Panchaka. He brought back the head of their father, joined it with the body, and performed a sacrifice by which their father came back to life and later occupied a seat among the 7 stars, the Saptarishis, in heaven. Parasurama was a great guru and he propagated the Vedas. It is said that he is immortal and that he lives in the Mahendra Mountains. After meeting Sri Rama, son of Dasharatha, he renounced all violence and lives in perfect meditation. Parasurama is considered as one of the 10 avatars of the Supreme, and that he was born only to relieve the burden of the earth, which was accomplished by destroying the Kshatriya race several times.